Oven mitts for sale. Oven mitts. Oven mitts for sale. Oven mitts.
Why, hello there, sir. I could use an oven mitt. In fact, I'll take two.
Here you go, kid. Enjoy.
All right. Thank you. This is just what I needed. This is, Hey, what's up with this?
Oh, well, that's my invention, see? You know, classic oven mitts. They're big and clumsy. So I cut out windows in the mitts. That way you can use your fingers while you're still using the mitts. Great idea, huh?
Wow, this seems incredibly dangerous. Have you tried this yourself?
Well, no, I'm not much of a cook. I'm more of what you'd call an oven mitt builder. Anyway, enjoy the oven mitts. Oven mitts for sale. Oven mitts. Oven mitts for sale. Oven mitts. Oven mitts for sale.
Huh, so maybe there's a lesson here. If you spend all your time building tools and don't actually use them once in a while, you can't really be sure they're any good. I'm just gonna put these down over here. See, we at Google don't wanna end up like our oven mitt selling friend, and that in a roundabout way explains why we released a game about pie throwing to the Google Play Store. Now, if you haven't checked it out yet, Pie Noon is a fast-paced action game where you square off against your friends in a pie throwing showdown. It's built by our Fun Propulsion Labs team, the same folks behind such hits as the Liquid Fun physics engine, but it does raise some important questions like, why is Google making games? Are we starting a game studio? What's up with that? Well, no. For starters, the monetization model is terrible. I mean, come on, where are the microtransactions, folks? No, we really made Pie Noon because we've been making some great new tools for C++ game developers, but we figured maybe it's time we put our money where our mouth is, when it's not full of pie, and demonstrate using some of these tools in a full-blown game. Then we can open source the project and let you see how we did everything. So let's go over some of this tech we used one at a time. First up, WebP. WebP is a new graphical format designed to keep your image file sizes tiny without sacrificing quality. Now, some people mistakenly think that WebP is just for web pages. Maybe it's the word web right there in the name, but it's not. You can use it in mobile apps as well. WebP supports lossy and lossless compression with lossless alpha channel support in both cases, and it will give you considerable size improvements over both JPEG and PNG files. Remember, graphic assets can often be the single largest component of your game, and not everybody is downloading your game over 4G networks onto 32 gig devices. For many people, bandwidth and file sizes are still real concerns, and the smaller you can make your game, the more likely people are to install and keep it on their device. For Pie Noon, our engineers started with Targa files, converted those to PNG assets, and then converted those to WebP format. It was these converted files that got used as the final assets in the game. And how'd it turn out? What started as, 42 meg of Targas became 10.7 meg of PNGs and ended up as a nice slim 1.4 meg of WebPs. In case you're curious, we went for lossy textures with a quality rating of 90, which gave us good balance between size and quality. You can judge the visual quality for yourself in the game or just experiment with our conversion tool and see what option looks best for you. Now granted, you can still take this a step further and export everything using GPU optimized textures, which we still highly recommend. But I know some developers don't want to deal with multiple texture formats for different chipsets, and for those people, WebP is a great alternative. Next up, let's talk about MathFu. MathFu is a cross-platform C++ library designed to quickly and easily perform common mathematical tasks that game developers encounter. So if you've got matrices that need multiplying, or quaternions that need slurping, or just need a randomly generated vector, MathFu can help you out. Now granted, there are many math libraries out there like this. But what differentiates MathFu from many of these others is twofold. First, it's optimized for SIMD chips, you know, like the one that is probably in your phone right now. And this is pretty significant. On a Nexus 5, you're looking at about a 5x speedup just by using the SIMD optimization. On a desktop machine, it's more like 20x. Second, MathFu was designed from the outset to be simple and streamlined. The developers did not throw in the kitchen sink here. They kept it focused just on performing tasks that game developers need. So if you're looking for a math library to help you like fold proteins or something, you should not use MathFu. There are better libraries out there for you. But if you're looking to make a game, this will cover all of your needs. And again, this was something the Pie Noon team set out to prove. The developers used it for everything from the particle system to the camera positioning to the parabolic pie paths, and it worked great for that. Finally, do you have level data, animation files, or saved game data in your game that you are defining as a giant block of JSON? Well, if you do, stop it. Seriously, stop it. Stop right now. Step away from the text editor. Look, JSON is great for producing human-readable data, But in order to make things human readable, you end up having to use a lot more space than you would use otherwise. And in many languages, your JSON to native code decoder is going to be slow, thanks to all the string parsing and type guessing work your decoder needs to do. Not only that, but the deserialization process is probably going to wreak havoc with your memory as a lot of temporary objects are allocated and deallocated. So to fix this problem, Google created a serialization library called FlatBuffers. This is an open source tool where you write out a schema describing your data, and the FlatBuffers library generates a C++ file that can convert a byte array to a native object and back without even having to unpack it, meaning that zero superfluous objects are allocated in memory. It's fast, way faster than reading in JSON files, it works cross-platform, it's strongly typed to avoid careless mistakes, and even has some nice versioning support for when you need to change your data format. So the PyNoon team used FlatBuffers to define everything from the location of their UI elements to their particle effects to storing all of their gameplay settings. But are you ready for the big twist? They authored these values using JSON files. So, okay, giant circle with the slash through it, you can go away now. There you go, look at that. You see, an intermediary step in the build process takes a FlatBuffer schema and a corresponding JSON file and converts the entire thing into a byte array, which can quickly be read in as a native object by the generated C++ file when the game starts. So you can check out the CMakeLists file in the project if you're interested in viewing all the dirty details. But I think the point to take away here is that the team got the convenience of still being able to author in a human-readable format, but the speed of nearly native code by using FlatBuffers. Now, this speed boost was huge from a relative standpoint. FlatBuffers are like 400 times faster than JSON. But in absolute numbers, it was actually modest just because this game didn't have a lot of data to load. So, you know, this whole speed up was pretty minor compared to everything else the game had to do at startup. But if your game happens to have large amounts of game data or save files, this can save you a ton of loading time. So there is some other tech the team used, like the build all Android script, which ended up being really useful to quickly iterate on a build, and a CPU profiler, which frankly ended up being not so useful because the game was actually GPU bound, but that's a whole other episode. Anyway, if you're interested in finding out more about any of these technologies, we have a whole list of links for you to follow in the description below. But more importantly, we have a link to the full project so you can try it out for yourself, fool around with the code, and build your own version of PyNoon. So you give it a try and enjoy. As for me, I'm gonna enjoy this delicious fresh baked pie. Holy mother of God, that's hot! Like I said, you can spend your days building tools, but unless you use them yourselves once in a while, you might get burned. Maybe literally. I'm Todd Kerfelman, and I'll see you soon.
You know what I love about working at Google? It's that no day is exactly the same. Every day brings its own unique challenges and surprises. For example.
Oh, you guys put your phones on silent and everything?
No one calls me anyway.
Sure they do.
Wrong numbers.
Huh.
I asked them to talk to me.
Hey Todd, I'm just checking. Does that smell okay?
What? Yeah, I think it smells fine. Why? I hate you, Jeff.